I want to start off today by saying that I feel sorry for you poor souls that bought the digital deluxe edition of Beyond Light, because you just got handed a real shit sandwich of a season and you've got no way to get your money back. I'll not mince words, we're 3 days into Season of the Chosen and I despise it. The story is executed poorly, the battlegrounds are boring, the Umbral Engrams and Prismatic Recaster have been reintroduced to the game half-assedly, and large pieces of content are just outright missing. And for a season that is 13 gigabytes in size, probably one of the biggest seasons that Bungie has ever shipped, I don't understand how they bungled it this badly. So what the hell happened here? Let's break it down, starting with the story. So first I want to say that the introduction of Empress Keitel to the game has been something that I've been looking forward to for the better part of a year now, ever since the Heir Apparent exotic first shipped. And I'll say this, I really like how they characterize Keitel in the opening cutscene of this season. She carries the same imposing presence that Gaul did back in D2 Vanilla, but also exhibits the diplomatic tact of her father, Kallus. And most importantly of all, she's the first Cabal leader that we've encountered that exhibits a code of honor. She could have easily executed Zavala and Osiris at that meeting. Gaul certainly would have, but that is not her way. But make no mistake, she is still Cabal through and through, and would rather see you bend the knee than for both parties to see mutual benefaction. However, once this opening cutscene with Keitel ends, it's all downhill from there. Keitel launches her invasion of the Sol System, and you get to play your first battleground on Nessus outside the giant battle tank that's also a factory. Then you get to go to the Helm, which is a new space Bungie created for this season. It's not even a social space, really, it's just a space for the season with limited NPCs and functionality. Here you find out that Zavala has appointed Lord Saladin as field commander, and that Crow has finally come to the tower and he will be providing support. Shortly after your first debriefing in the Helm, you end up going to Europa to do a second battleground because the Red Legion are apparently trying to create Exo-Cabal. I have no idea how the Cabal know what happened on Europa and Beyond Light, but you play yet another boring battleground, which really isn't much different from the first one, other than it has a new boss. But by the end of this battleground, you have your seasonal artifact and you have a new thing called the Hammer of Proving, which is essentially a neutered version of the Cryptolith lure from last season. You need it to both open chests at the end of battleground activities and to focus your Umbral Engrams. Which, by the way, if you don't buy Season of the Chosen, the moment the intro quest ends, the game will abruptly remove the Hammer of Proving from your inventory. And it just sits there at the ward table, in your face, with a red banner that says you need to buy the season. Like a carrot on the end of a stick, taunting you, seducing you, and trying to psychologically manipulate you into parting with your $10. It's a sham, my friends, and you shouldn't fall for it. As for the story at this point, once the intro quest is over, the story just abruptly stops. Is this uncommon for a season to do? Not really. Is it a major letdown for the people who did get the pass? Absolutely. So let's recap. We had a fantastic opening sequence with Keitel, two subpar battleground activities, an unnecessarily lengthy and boring intro quest, and the new space whose only purpose is to spout exposition at you and allow you to decrypt your umbral engrams. A lot of this seems oddly familiar. Come on, it's moving to the front of my brain. Oh, wait. It's Season of the Worthy all over again. And that should tell you everything you need to know. So, the story's bunk. Let's move on to the next point of discussion, the battlegrounds. Now, as a free player of the season, I got to do three battlegrounds. I got to do the Behemoth one on Nessus twice, and the Hailstone one on Europa once. And I was not impressed all three times. It's like Bungie went back to the Black Armory forges and removed all the fun. Seriously, the battlegrounds are just another three-man horde mode. You kill lots of enemies, you throw batteries, you blow up generators, and you kill a boss. But whereas the Black Armory Forge ignitions were engaging, battlegrounds have the gameplay depth and innovation of a kiddie pool. And also, with the Black Armory Forges, you could target the specific weapons you wanted to drop. Battlegrounds? No such thing. Now, you could argue that that's what the recaster's for, but if you're free, you don't get to use it. And second, even if you've got the pass, focusing your umbral engrams does not guarantee you what you want. What a spectacularly bad design decision. And speaking of bad design decisions, let's talk about the umbral engrams in the recaster. So first off, if you went through all the trouble in Season of Arrivals of getting your recaster fully maxed out, getting all the focuses, doing everything, all of that progress is erased. And also, despite the fact that many of us paid for the ability to use the recaster back in Season of Arrivals, they've taken it and resold it back to us in this season. If you want to focus pretty much any of your umbral engrams, you have to pay for Season of the Chosen. So Bungie has effectively double dipped. And finally, the greatest crime of all. The umbral decoder no longer speaks to you using Drifter's voice. Now, the decoder just sits there, staring back at you, like the heartless, cold machine that it is. And Drifter himself said back in Season of Arrivals, his decoder is like a cryptarch that won't judge you. Only in Season of the Chosen, the cryptarchs have hijacked the decoder and demand their $10 tax. Disgusting. The umbral engram should have never been brought back in this state. And speaking of things that should not have been brought out, let's talk about the helm. As I said before, it's a pseudo-social space. It's not a real one because there are no other players around, and there's only a small amount of vendors and NPCs that you can access here. You can get to your postmaster, you can get to your vault, you can decode your umbral engrams, you can go to the war table, and you can talk to Crow, but he's got nothing. Basically, this space is mostly intended for in-game cutscenes where they spout some exposition at you throughout the season. That's it. Oh, and if you thought you could decrypt your prime engrams in the helm and save you a trip to the tower, think again. There are no resident cryptarchs in the helm. And the funny part about it is, Tyra Karn is the one that rebuilt the recaster and the umbral decoder for the helm. So where is her old wrinkled ass? She should be here decrypting my primes, not hiding in the shadows somewhere forgetting who people are. And so, the way the helm is set up now, I have to come to the helm first. Every time I finish a couple of activities, I have to offload my umbral engrams. Then I have to do a separate load screen to go to the tower to decrypt primes and get bounties. Who is the member of management at Bungie that thought this was okay? It isn't. It's purpose-built to waste players' time. And speaking of Bungie's management, who was the one that signed off on all the content that's currently missing? Because as of right now, reputation rank rewards are missing from Zavala, even though they were promised. The ability to pick up bounties from the director while in orbit is missing. The rocket yards and grotto in the Cosmodrome Patrol are missing. Also, the strike icons for both the new Fallen Saber and Sepix Prime Strikes are missing. And to my knowledge, no one has been able to access Fallen Saber through the strike playlist at this time. So all I can surmise is that it's missing. 13 gigabyte season, and substantial pieces of it are missing. Were you all just too busy nerfing Stasis and Eyes of Tomorrow that you forgot to ship a third of the season out? The way it looks, it seems so. And let me tell you, Sepix Prime not being on the director is a real crime, because I've played Nightfall the Ordeal. I don't have any footage to show you of it, but I have played it. It's probably one of the best Nightfalls in Destiny 2. It is pure nostalgic bliss. So much better than their rework of Omnigul. Miles ahead. They should have never touched her. And I can't comment on Fallen Saber right now because I can't fucking play it! And trust me when I say, I really want to find some level of enjoyment in this season. I really do. I try every season to do that. Even Season of the Worthy when it was just god-awful. But it's so hard to enjoy this season when you have all the aforementioned issues, plus a really shitty power grind on top of it. Why in the unholy name of the Winnower did they do a 50-point power increase for this season? Nobody wanted it. In fact, I recall before Beyond Light, Bungie put out a survey asking the player base if they would prefer 10-point increases for each season rather than the 50s they were doing. And I recall that it was a resounding yes. So what happened to that survey? Did some member of management just print it out one day and decide to wipe their ass with it at lunchtime? For all this talk of, we're listening, your actions, Bungie, show the complete opposite. And if your intention was to create a Season of the Worthy 2.0, then congratulations, you succeeded. And for that, you don't get my money. We'll talk again in Season 14. But in the meantime, clean up your act. Well, anyway, I'm done ranting for today. So now I turn to you, the viewer. Did this season leave you with a gaping void in your heart as big as the one we saw in the trailer with the derelict Cabal ship? Or is this season exactly what you asked for? Let me know in the comments below. And as always, if you like the video, make sure you give it a thumbs up, and if you dislike the video, show it to your enemies. And with that, I leave things here. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you next time.